Hi guys, so I've just left the house and I'm on my own today. I'm going off building works. I'm going off to see if I can find the Museum of Musical Instruments. So it's raining. Rob said you want to take an umbrella and I said why? Because I'm not used to being in a house where you can't hear the rain on the roof. So when I noticed it was raining, I said yes to the umbrella. So I'm just leaving his apartment now and heading off into town. So hello Brussels. Hi guys, it's raining really badly today and I've just trekked halfway across the city because I'm looking for the Museum of Musical Instruments. I would really like to see a piano. but as I was walking, I did notice that behind me there is, I don't know if you can see that, but there's a little tower in the background. So I found one pretty thing on a really grey day. Guys, the first part of this video is going to be an unabashed gush about pianos. I found my happy place here in Brussels. I noticed on a number of the early pianos that the soundboards have a hole through them like a guitar. I also noticed that quite a few of the old pianos have detailing on the key edges.
Was this for decoration, or did it serve a purpose? I'd love to know. That was something I noticed about the museum. The information was pretty rudimentary. I would have loved some more detailed information about why certain pianos were designed the way they were, like the giraffe piano in the pyramid. Why did sound holes disappear? And why did the standard keyboard switch from black with white sharps to white with black sharps? The introduction of cross frames in the 1850s was a very interesting development in piano history, as was the whole birdcage piano era, but neither are mentioned. I get that this type of information would probably bore most visitors to death, but if you have one of the world's finest collections of historic pianos, you've got to expect a few piano enthusiasts to rock up. When you enter the museum, you get an audio headset. You type in the number next to an instrument and get to listen to how it sounds. It's a really nice touch. Sadly, some of the most interesting pieces weren't on there. I'd love to hear how the dog kennel sounded and this gorgeously decorative upright. This one is my favourite in the whole collection. I didn't understand what it was at first, but then I realised it's a piano that plays like a violin. These rather steampunk cogs turn a set of leather straps that rub against the strings like a bow. This is a corpse bride kind of piano. I love gothic looking instruments like this. On the next floor, they have a collection of almost every type of instrument, documenting musical evolution from the earliest bone whistles to the most elaborate modern instruments. I think I might have enjoyed playing the recorder at school a little bit more if it looked like this. This is another instrument that works similarly to the piano viola. Trust me to find all the pianos in the room. These appear to be early bagpipes. Another piano. This one has mother of pearl keys. The building itself is very beautiful.
Oh, I've just come out of the museum and I'm really close to that tower now. I'm wondering if I should go down there because I desperately need something to eat. The cafe in the museum is closed. Just discovered this place, Hotel Ravenstein. Looks like something out of Harry Potter, some sort of Hogwarts school. Wow, it's a rainy day.
There are some absolutely wonderful looking sweet shops in Brussels. I didn't go in, but I definitely will next time. It was just lovely to look at the window displays. ended up in this lovely little Indian restaurant off the main drag. They do a thali, which is a selection of dishes with rice, naan and a piece of dessert. The vegetarian one was €25 and the meat one was €30. They can feed two averagely hungry people or one very hungry person, which I was. I rounded it up with kulfi, which is traditional cardamom ice cream. Feeling incredibly full, content and sleepy, I wandered off to the Van Gogh exhibition.
Fears both the calmness and the chaos, both the darkness of the night and the night's brilliant colour.
I forgot how much I miss art exhibitions. €15 buys you an afternoon's entertainment and culture. I went in thinking it was just a display of paintings, but it turned out to be an incredibly relaxing multimedia experience. There was even a recreation of his room in the Yellow House at Arles. And this beautiful room dedicated to his obsession with Japan. The walls and the floors were constantly changing, and you could stand up or sit down on the floor to watch it. It was very trippy at times, and I really enjoyed it. In all, it was a really wonderful day.